Well, so anything that doesn't feel good, reduce the range of movement first, but you can also cease as well and have longer rest. So when in doubt, cat camel, so spine to ceiling, shoulders away from ears, exhale, rib cage in, belly button into spine. Into the cow, looking up to the ceiling. Nice and slow until you get mobilized. I definitely need this week. Another five. Deep breaths.
Exhale in the cat.
The more you move your pelvis forwards and backwards,
the more blood flow to that lower back.
From here, we're going to go into the disco
cat, so big circles
with the hips. You can relax the neck as well.
You're just working in big circles.
Rib cage in, belly button into spine. Shoulders up and down
as you work through the cat cow.
If this is uncomfortable, just go back to the cat cow. Change direction. And back to cat cow.
Exhale in the cat,
spine to ceiling. A big curve as you're extending the spine, flexing. Okay, we're gonna continue mobilizing the spine. So we don't do much of this movement in everyday life. So I'm gonna keep nice and mobile with thread the needle. So bending in that supporting arm, following your gaze with your hand all the way up and over as far around as you can go. Start off slow because it can be quite uncomfortable until you mobilize. Pushing through as far as you can. Shoulders away from ears. Dropping the hips. Another five. Allow yourself to feel that stretch in the hips and the lower back. Just feel one more. Good, change opposite side now. 10 to 12, we're looking for. Again, start off slow until you mobilize. Just feel it. Three more. Good. Last 10 cat cow.
Exhale in the cat.
Allow yourself to stretch that back
as much as you can.
Okay, so we're going to work on some upper shoulder strength, so upper body strength. I'm going to bring our arms up to the side and down. One arm only, looking for 10 to 12, as far back as you can. Shoulder height. Take note of any fatigue, twinges, soft arm, so slight bend in the elbow and that in the supporting arm. As far back as you can. connect it, note roughly where it is, because you're going to compare each side. Rib cage in, stop it from flaring out. Belly button into spine, so you're tensing like someone's punching your abs. You don't want to feel it. So you'll feel this in the supporting arm as well. Keep going, because we're working on shoulder stability on that side too. Two more. Good. Let's go to the other side. Let's compare. 10 to 12, or as many as you can. This is your starting point as well. Another four. One more. Good. Next, we're going to take our hand and just put it next to our heads. We're going to come in. It's a bit like a thread the needle. Look round as far around as you can. Curling in and opening the chest. Good. And looking round as far around as you can for 10 reps, or as many as you can. That's five. One more. Good. Let's swap to the other side. See how we get on. So hopefully that stabilizing arm. We'll start to feel that, Nick. It's taking your time. Another six. Three. Two more. Shake off those arms if you need to. I'm going to do another set of those exercises. So we started with the front and to the side, looking for 10 to 12 reps when you're ready. The slower you do it, the harder it is, because muscles under tension for longer. Make sure after this class you get your protein. So you've got 48 hours around the exercise window to gain enough protein to build and repair new muscle. Another six if you can. Three, two, one more. Good, over to the other side. One for 12. Again, keep them abs engaged as you breathe through it. Another five. Hopefully that shoulder's burning on the opposite side as well now. Two. More. Good. I'm going to do that twist again with the elbow in and round for 10 altogether if you can. Or just to do as many as you can and rest in between. Everybody's different. You're able to concentrate on what you can do rather than what you can't. Yet. Five left. One more, and over to the other side, excellent. Good. Grab a drink if you need to. You need to shake off. It's quite warm in this room, isn't it? I'm going to go be in the seated position next, so whatever's comfortable. So shoulders up and down, big circles. Be aware of any tightness, any limited ranges of movement from either side. And forwards. Looking for a warm sensation in that shoulder joint deep. Good, arms come out, shoulders down away from ears, relax. Small circles back. Soft elbow, but slight bend. Deep breaths. Ten, nine, good. Eight, just to shoulder height, seven, six, five, chest proud, four, three, two, one. Arms come back for pulses, so midline to back, squeezing the shoulder blades together, 10, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Last time if you can, back to the center, 10, 9, let it burn, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and back, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest the arms, good, hopefully the ache in there, feeling that, a few seconds rest, and do that set once more. So I'm expecting failure, dropping your arms, shake them off, and then back up, okay? That's how we build strength and tone. Three, two, one, small circles. 10, 9, 8, shoulders away from ears. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, deep breaths. 1, and back. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Last time, round 10, 9, 8, 7. Deep breath, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And back, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Good, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest there. Burning, 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 burning. Good. Big shoulder circles back. Chest proud, ribcage in, belly button into spine. I'm just going to turn round and open up the chest. One arm on your leg. Just relax and sink into that. Deep breaths. From here, both legs come out. And the one that you've got your hand on, crossing over, relax and sink in. It's a bit of a glute stretch, deep lower back. Come round a little bit further if you can. Take your time, we're gonna swap that over. So I'm just gonna stay here until you get used to the stretch, and then we'll do the crossover. Now let's cross over that leg, deep breath, and on the exhale, move around as far as you can. Sink into the mat. Excellent. We're going to go back into tabletop position. So you will feel more on your shoulders because we've pre-exhausted them with that isolation work there. So cat-cow, let's remobilize the spine. Nice and steady. We're going to go for five. Inhale. Exhale in the cat. Another two. Knees together, child's pose. Come up, do a Pilates push-up. So it doesn't matter how far down you go, elbows to the back of the room behind you. Even if it's a small pulse, you're isolating the tricep, the back of the arm, to tone that. Shoulders, nice, good. So palms directly under the shoulder, going for 10. Or as many as you can, even if the pulse is very small, you will increase the range of movement as you get stronger. And this is tough because you're isolating that weak tricep muscle. It's only a small muscle. Four left. Three, it's like a cramping. Two, one more. Good, back into child's pose. Back into the push-ups, Pilates version, so you're dipping more. Good, going for another 10, two, three, five, six, seven, excellent, eight, one more. Child's pose. Last 10 if you can, or you can go to cat camel. Even if it's a small pulse, that's fine. Last 10, let it burn, pinch, cramp. Totally depends on how you feel it, but it's all good. Shoulders away from ears. Five, four, three. Good, two more, one more. Child's pose. Excellent. So tabletop position again next. Opposite arm to opposite leg. So I'm going to come up and hold for 10 seconds before beginning 10 reps. So ribcage in, belly button into spine. Shoulder height and hip height, your legs should be no higher. Five, four, three, two, one. 10 reps if you can. Coming right in, crunching and back up. Getting blood flow to that lower back and keeping mobile. Good one for spinal stability and strength. Six, seven, eight. One more. 10. Good. Good. That felt good. Come out again, opposite side. I'm going to hold that for 10. Nine. Shoulders away from ears. Seven. Four, three, two, one. So come in for 10 or as many as you can. Five, six, seven, eight. Good. Into child's pose. Stretch that off. Grab a drink if you need one before we begin the next set of those. Okay, tabletop position. Opposite arm to opposite leg for that 10 second hold again before we begin 10 reps. Good. 10, 9, ribcage in, belly button into spine. 6, deep breaths. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's come in and out for 10. 2, three. Nice and controlled, coming down. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good, let's swap over. I'm ready. 10 second hold, ten, nine, ribcage in, seven, six, five, three, two, one. Let's come in and out. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Last two. Good. We'll cat camel five. Exhale in the cat. One more. So if you're feeling this in the cat camel on the wrists, feel free to go onto the fists or just keep shaking off until you build that strength. You can feel that if you've got carpal tunnel. Next, we're going to go into, so getting blood flow to the lower back before we start isolating the back muscles. So toes underneath heels, heel to ceiling for donkey kicks. Looking for 12 to 15, squeezing that bum cheek on the highest movement. So this is forcing a cat camel again in the in the pelvis, rocking forwards and backwards. Good. Again, nice and controlled coming down. You'll feel it in the stabilizing leg as well. It's good. Five, four, three, two, one more. Then with the same leg, I'm gonna go into a big half rainbow, so that full rainbow even. Again, so make sure your hips aren't swaying. Nice and controlled. Looking for 10 to 12. 7, 8, 10, 11, 12. Good. Last set on this side. Heel to ceiling for donkey kicks. Squeezing that bum cheek, the top of the movement. Another five, two, one more. Excellent. Rainbows, 12, two, three, ten. Good. Let's do some cat camel. Let's remobilize, make sure everything's okay. Going for five. Good. Grab a drink if you need one. I'm going to be in the prone position next. Working on isolating the back muscles next to the spine, which takes pressure off the spine. Good for posture, reducing the risk of osteoporosis and osteoarthritis, and reduces fall risks. Stabilizes the spine. And we're also going to the back of the shoulder now, so shoulder strength and stability. So first things first, dorsal raises. So you're pushing yourself off the mat as high as you can, so that's what you're aiming for. But if you've not done it in a while or for like much, don't come up as much. You slowly, it's more important that you slowly come down to the floor. Come in, so your hands are just by your head, squeezing your shoulders at the back and slowly coming down. So elbows to the back of the room. Looking for higher reps, 12 to 15. coming up as far up as you can. So legs fly for a beginner, or if you want a more challenge, bring your legs up as well as you push yourself off the mat. Inhale on the rise, exhale coming down. Squeezing them shoulder blades together at the top. Even pause if you can, that's even better. Muscles under tension for longer. So you'll start to feel a burning sensation using the lower back, but if you've got weaknesses in the upper, you may feel it there as well, or the shoulder. Another five. Four. Two more. Good. A few seconds rest, then we're going to do that set again. Just waiting for the lactic acid to clear, burning to stop. We're going to go in for another 15, if you can, or as many as you can while that burn. Push up. Another five if you can. Three. Two. One more. Good. Into child's pose. Stretch that off. Take your time into child's pose. Slowly come down.
Sink in. Deep breath.
Good. Next one, we'll go into semi-supine. So on our backs, bending at the knees. I'm going to work on some glutes and ab work. So first, I'm going to bring our knees in for a hug and roll, side to side. Blades to move your left to right. Side to your back, it feels good. Okay, so we're going to talk about correct core engagement and recruitment of all those six abdominal muscles. So, because it's a beginner's class, ribcage in, so normally it's like out, we want to keep it tucked in. But the lower abs, below the belly button, is where a lot of connections are lost, and this is why lower back pain occurs, because of the breakdown of your lower back, it's the opposing muscle. So ribcage in to contract the upper abs, but you're going to push out your belly button into your spine, so push it down into the floor, and that's going to flatten that curve that was in your back. So your whole back, no curves, your whole back's now touching the mat. That is the role of your abs, to keep your back flat against the mat. When there's a breakdown, this recruitment, so you can have a poke around, it should feel a little bit of tension or a lot, not using be a little bit of a tension, but you definitely know that there's something there. From here, I'm going to bring one leg up into tabletop and then follows the other leg. So again, make sure the back's fully against the floor, ribcage stays tucked in like someone's punching you in the stomach. Just start to burn after a while. From here, we're going to start flutter kicks. So if you can get right down without your back coming off the floor, excellent. I can't yet, so it's totally up to you. And your hands are just going to stay by your side. You can keep checking in, make sure the whole abs, there's tension there. Some people lose the sides of the stomach, you know, the waist. There should be tension everywhere. Deep breath. Stay stubborn, keep that ribcage tucked in, push that belly button down into the spine. Five, four, three, two, one, good. Coming back down into semi-supine. Inhale, arms rise. Shoulders away from ears. Exhale. relaxation breaths. Inhale, fill the full lungs with oxygen. Pause at the top with full lungs before exhaling through the mouth. Inhale, raises your heart rate. Pause at the top, slow exhale, relaxes the heart rate. Again, inhale, relax the abs and pull, and there, and the pelvic floor. Exhale, pull in the abs and pelvic floor. So inhale, like you're on the toilet, you're passing gas, urine. Exhale, holding everything in, including your abs. Just speak to me after class if you want me to go more into this, connecting to the pelvic floor. One more. Good, again, legs back into tabletop, rib cage in, switch to full core on, belly button into spine, back fully against the rest. This time we're gonna come off, shoulders off the floor, crunching in, and as you crunch in, your knees pulse in, and up and down,
and up,
slowly coming down. So we're looking for a burning sensation, and the point is,
you're holding on to that burning sensation as long as you can. This builds new muscle and strength
for next time,
if you get your protein.
So the slower you come down,
the more you're going to build,
and the harder it is.
Inhale at the top, exhale.
Coming down, good.
Another 10, if you can. Searching for that burning
the abs.
Shouldn't be clicking or anything. If there's any clicking in the hips, it can mean there's a breakdown in the core recruitment.
Last five. Three. Two.
One more.
Good. Knees in for a hug and roll, relax. And into semi-supine. Inhale, arms rise, fill in the lungs. Pause at the top. Exhale, joining the abs and the pelvic floor. You don't want to pass gas or urine. Inhale, relax everything, pushing the abs out. Pause at the top. Exhale. Tune into that pelvic floor. Inhale, relax everything. Exhale, holding everything in, tensing. Another three. Good. Legs back into tabletop, so ribcage in, belly button into spine. Have a poke around, is everything engaged? This time, I'm going to bring our legs out and in. So the point of this is to keep the tension in the abs. So this could, but you are making the point to squeeze your abs as tight as you can. Tune in, and they'll start burning. This is good for hip mobility as well, and that lower core. 10. Nine, as wide as you can. Eight, with keeping those abs engaged. Seven, six, five, four. Good. Two more. Let it burn. One more. Good. Hug and roll. Side. Five breaths, semi-supine. Inhale, shoulders away from ears. Pause. Another three. More. Good. Good. Legs into tabletop and arms into tabletop. Back fully against the floor as normal. Rib cage in, belly button into spine. We're going to start dead bug track walk. So again, keeping the tension in the abs. If you come right down and your back stay against the floor. Excellent. I can't. It's totally individual. As long as you can feel it in your abs, squeeze your abs as tight as you can. Inhale, exhale. Excellent. Excellent, Alex. Good. Deep breaths. You might feel at the top of the thigh. Those are your hip flexors. That's good. So need strong hip flexors for strong abs. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, no clicking, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, hug and roll. Excellent. So if you had any hip clicking there, it's just gone a little bit too fast at the moment. Just dial it back a little bit. Semi-super, 5 breaths, inhale.
So this is, we right now are working on relaxing your peripheral nervous system, help you sleep at night.
Just a side note as well, if you notice yourself shallow breathing, like you can't catch a deep breath throughout like a stressful day, usually means that you're shallow breathing subconsciously. So just take some time to deep breath and get that oxygen in. Next, if we're up for it, you can stay in tabletop position because it's a bit like a plank, but it's super safe. Or
you can do bicycle crunch. Again, can come right out if you've got the ab engagement, or you can do a pulse like I am. So looking left and right, opposite arm to opposite leg. Good. So this is a Pilates crisscross. Ribcage in, belly button into spine. 20, 19. One,
done, hug and roll. Excellent. Well done. We're gonna put our feet together on the floor and our knees out. Just relax into that. So you should have a small curve in this spine. Well, actually some people's is bigger than others. It's totally individual, your neutral spine. Inhale, arms rise, shoulders away from ears. Another 4. Working with the pelvic floor. Inhale, push the pelvic floor and abs out. Making room for the oxygen. Exhale, holding and pulling everything in like a zip from anus up to the belly button. Take note of any tightness in the inner groin. Is it one side more than the other? Try and relax. One more. Good. Both knees over to one side, and you're going to look the opposite side for book openings.
This one,
if you're ever quite tight, yeah. Or back in good. It's a good one. Deep breath. I'm going to stay in this for a few seconds. Sink into the mat. So switch your shoulders off, they can tense up. Switch off your glutes. Just allow yourself to feel that in the lower back. You can stay here, or if you feel comfortable enough, put your bottom leg over your top to increase that stretch again. Allow yourself to sink into the mat. Obviously, you can't switch off that leg, but you can your hips. Let it pull. And breathe.
more seconds.
Carefully come out of that stretch. I'm going to do the other side when you're on time. Can be a bit stiff moving over. Let's see how you are this side. Again, switch off those muscles, sink into the mat. If you're okay on this side, bottom leg over the top and sink in. Going to stretch the arms and legs as far around, far away from the belly button line, the mid-center. Big stretch. Take time. Going to sit up into the seated position. Going to stretch off the hamstrings because they get quite tight. Going to pull the pelvis backwards, causing a flat back, another back pain. So first we'll do the inner thigh and hamstrings. So just going to hold this position. So ideally, legs flat with a slight bend in the elbow, knees. Deep breaths. This is, can be a lower back stretch as well. Shoulders away from ears. Try and relax. We've worked these muscles, they're nice and warm, so should be nice and safe to move in and develop the flexibility. So take a deep breath in. On the exhale, let's move in further to that stretch. Can we bring our feet together? Isolating them hamstrings now. So it feels like a mild discomfort in the back of the leg. It shouldn't be painful. If it is, just dial it back a bit. You've likely gone too far. Shouldn't be getting pins and needles either. Deep breaths will help you relax. Underrated component of fitness, flexibility. Take a deep breath in. And if you feel able, move into that stretch on the exhale. Even just a little bit. One more deep breath in. Exhale, move in. Excellent. Thank you everyone for coming, and I'll see you in a couple of weeks. You've got to fall asleep, you. If you've got any feedback or anything you want to chat about, I'm here for it.